Russ, if people just mean, like, you want that triple-double average now, right? Like, forget about all season. Right now, it's the last game. You need 16 boards. You're going to try and get that, right? Don't deny that. It's obvious you wanted it. It's good that you wanted it. And I'm happy to be alive to have seen it.
It doesn't matter what the scenario is. Russell Westbrook should be ticked off. And the reason why he should be ticked off has absolutely positively nothing to do with numbers, not even his level of production. It's the fact that this man never, ever cheats us with effort. That's what this comes down to. I challenge one basketball fan in the entire universe, anywhere you want to go around the globe, to tell me one night, including all-star, meaningless all-star exhibition games, show me one night where you've watched Russell Westbrook and you didn't see max effort. One time. You'll never find it. This dude never, ever cheats. He goes out and he goes all out, all the time.
Yes, so I've heard the news. Russell Westbrook is going to Houston. He's teaming up with James Harden yet again. They went from the 8th seed to the 4th seed to the number 2 seed 3 consecutive years before finishing their tenure together in an NBA Finals berth against the Miami Heat. Losing to LeBron James and those boys in 5. We know this, D-Wade, of course. But here's the bottom line. We've been talking about the Los Angeles Lakers. We've been talking about the Los Angeles Clippers. How about the Houston Rockets now?
He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. And when you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. And I'm here to tell you, number one, that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want to party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep. Some of you love sleep more than you love success. And I'm here to tell you today, if you're going to be successful, you got to be willing to give up sleep. You got to be willing to work off for 3 hours of sleep, 2 hours. If you really want to be successful, some days you will have to stay up 3 days in a row. Because if you go to sleep, you might miss the opportunity to be successful. That's how bad you got to want it. Listen to me. You got to want to be successful so bad that you forget to eat. Beyonce said once she was on the set doing her thing, 3 days had gone by, she forgot she didn't eat. Because she was engaged. I'll never forget when 50 Cent was doing his movie, I did a little research on 50, and 50 said that when he wasn't doing the movie, he was doing the soundtrack. And they said, when do you sleep, 50? Sleep, he said, sleep. Sleep is for those people who are broke. I don't sleep. Said, I got an opportunity to make a dream become a reality.
Westbrook all the way to the basket and the bucket. Russell Westbrook got his wheels on and scores it. Russell pulls up at the nail and scores. Thunder on the high side. Dallas out of timeouts. Farrell kicks it to Barnes to straightaway three. No. Time expires and the Thunder wins. Thunder wins. Thunder wins!
Do you believe it? Because I do.
They're now 2-for-15 from downtown. Oladipo hits a three. He said to Kevin Durant, I'm coming,